What is up, guys? It's New York Sports Up here, back at it with another New York Yankees video. And not going to be a Knicks video today. The Knicks are off tonight, so not going to be having a Knicks video. It's going to be a Yankee video, and I'm going to talk about the Darren O'Day signing as well as the Kyle Bearclaw signing. There are two relievers that the Yankees added to their bullpen today. Both of those guys I expect to be on the Major League team at some point next season, and I'm going to talk about them in this video. And this is going to be my first of many Yankee videos this year. I haven't done a whole lot. Obviously, there hasn't not really been a lot to talk about. It was a very slow offseason to start. And then the Yankees obviously made a lot of moves this past month, getting trading Adam Ottavino to the Red Sox, getting DJ LeMahieu. George Springer went to the Blue Jays. The Yankees also signed Corey Kluber as well as Jameson Taillon. So the Yankees added to the pit starting rotation this year. They didn't really add to the bullpen. The bullpen was definitely very disappointing last year. I thought the bullpen was going to be one of the best in baseball. It was very disappointing. Look at the numbers from the with the bullpen last year. It was very disappointing. And I do expect the bullpen to be better this year. And the Yankees just improved it today by adding Kyle Bearclaw and as well as adding Darren O'Day last week. And I get it's kind of old news at this point, but I kind of wanted to make, two signings in one video, so I didn't have to do it in separate, because the Darren O'Day signing was kind of a small, a minor signing, so I didn't want to, put it into different videos. So I'm going to do it into one video. I'm going to be talking about the Darren O'Day signing as well as the Kyle Bearclaw signing. So let's start off by talking about Darren O'Day and what he could bring to this New York Yankees team. All right, so the first reliever of two that we're going to be talking about in this video, we're going to start off with the 38-year-old reliever, Darren O'Day. He formerly was of the Atlanta Braves. He pitched very well for the Atlanta Braves last year. In fact, I think he pitched phenomenally for the Braves last year. As you look at his numbers, they were fantastic. In a small sample size, 19 games, so it was a very small sample size, had a 4-0 record, a 1.10 ERA. For a 38-year-old pitcher, that is really good. And he was surrounded by guys in the Braves bullpen who are very good. Guys like Will Smith, guys like Chris Martin, guys like Mark Melanson. And Darren O'Day had phenomenal numbers, and he was definitely probably overshadowed by guys in that bullpen that are already really good and a lot more well-known. Well, Darren O'Day is not really well-known. He's probably more known, for being on the Orioles, but he was phenomenal for the Braves and actually one of their best relievers last year and was really good. I mean, he is pretty much an automatic out when he goes up against right-handed hitters. I mean, right-handed hitters cannot touch Darren O'Day. He's a horrible matchup for right-handed hitters, and that can really benefit, your team if, most of major league hitters are right-handed. And if you have Darren O'Day on the mound, the right-handed hitters probably are not going to get on base. So Darren O'Day is a very, very good, reliever to have in the back end of your bullpen. He's going to eat up some innings. He'd be a very good guy for the playoffs. He'd be a good guy to eat up innings, and obviously a good guy for matchups. And I really like Darren O'Day. I really like the signing. I know he's very old, he's very up there in age, and he's at the end of his career, but I think this will be a very good signing for the New York Yankees, and will improve, this bullpen, I think, massively. I think he will be better than Adam Ottavino. Adam Ottavino had a very disappointing season. Now, I know numbers-wise, you could take a look at 2019, and you could say Adam Ottavino is an elite reliever. I really don't think so. Adam Ottavino walks a ton of guys. Darren O'Day does not walk guys. Darren O'Day throws a lot of strikes, and he's going to get the job done pretty much every time he comes out to the mound. Did not have a save last year, did not really pitch in the closer role, but pitched in 16 innings, had 22 strikeouts. Darren O'Day had a very good year, and I expect him to have a pretty good year for the Yankees and be a very valuable guy out of the bullpen for the Yankees this year. I want to know your thoughts on Darren O'Day and the signing down in the comments. Now let's get into Kyle Bearclaw. All right, so the second of two relievers we are going to be talking about in this video is going to be Kyle Bearclaw, formerly of the San Diego Padres. And Kyle Bearclaw has been all around the major leagues throughout his career. He was with the Minnesota Twins. He was with the St. Louis Cardinals. He was with the Miami Marlins. He was with a ton of other teams. And he has never really had a great career. I mean, you look at the numbers. In 2015, he had a 2.59 ERA. And 2.85, 3.00, 4.20, 5.61, and then 6.66, number of the devil, that's kind of creepy, and then 2.25 ERA with the San Francisco Giants. And he's never really been a guy that's been a top-notch reliever. He's never really been that kind of guy, but he has been a decent back-end-of-the-bullpen kind of guy, and, throughout his career has been very solid. And he did not pitch in 2020, I'm not sure why. I don't even know if he was on a team last year, but he was on a team in 2019. but I'm not going to go over his 2019 numbers. I'm just going to go over his career numbers. He had a 2.1 WAR, 16 wins, 14 losses in his career, a 3.53 ERA, which is very solid, and 270 career games, 11 saves. So he has been a closer on a team before. Probably it was for the Marlins, because I don't remember them ever having a good bullpen. He's pitched in 252 innings, 319 strikeouts, and a 1.359 WHIP, and he's a guy that I feel like not a lot of people know about. He's only 30 years old. He's a young guy, and he's a right-handed pitcher. I think he could be a decent back end of the bullpen kind of guy to go along with guys like Sessa and Nick Nelson and Jonathan Loaisiga. All those guys, you know, Ben Heller, all those guys in the back end of the bullpen. Maybe he can be the new Jonathan Holder and another guy that can eat up innings for the Yankees. And in a bullpen that weak, in a weak bullpen that the Yankees have right now, I think Kyle Barraclough could be a decent pitcher. We bring him over. We call him up to the big leagues. I don't know if he'll start the season with the team. We'll see how he looks in spring training. Maybe we'll call him up to the big leagues at some point. And maybe he can be effective out of the bullpen. Overall, I'm going to grade this trade. I'm going to grade this signing. I'll give it a B. I think Kyle Barraclough can be a decent signing. Give us some length. He can be depth out of the bullpen. And he's not anything special. You know, he's not a great reliever. He's not even close to being a great reliever. But again, he could be a guy that can eat up some innings, you know, out of the bullpen and be a good back end kind of guy. So I want to know your thoughts on the Kyle Barraclough signing down in the comments. It's a minor league deal. Nothing crazy. We didn't spend a whole lot of money on him. I want to know your thoughts on the signing down in the comments below. And yeah, that's going to do it. All right, so that's going to do it. I talked about the Darren O'Day signing and the Kyle Barraclough minor league signing. You know, I kind of talked about their stats, and I talked about what I expect them to be for the Yankees out of the bullpen next season. And I want to know your expectations for both those players down in the comments below. I'd love to know your thoughts. Do you think we overpaid for Darren O'Day? Do you think it was a perfectly fine, you know, contract that we gave him? I believe it was like, what, $1.8 million? So it's nothing expensive, you know, nothing crazy. And he's 38 years old, so he's not going to ask for, like, a fortune. So I think it was I think they're both of those signings that the Yankees made were very good, very decent. I'd probably give the Darren O'Day signing an A-. I think it's a very, very under-the-radar signing. I really like it for the Yankees. I think he'll be a innings eater out of the bullpen, and again, be very good for, very good for matchups, especially against right-handed hitters, as I brought up when I was talking about him. So I don't know your thoughts in the comments down in the comments on the signings of Darren O'Day and Kyle Barraclough. Make sure to stay tuned for more Yankee content on the page coming very soon. Also, make sure to stay tuned for the All Things Baseball YouTube channel. I'll probably link it in the description below, so if you guys do want to check it out, I'd really appreciate it. I don't think I have any subscribers yet, so if you do want to check out the channel, I'd really appreciate it. I'm probably going to upload my first baseball video probably on Friday, after school's over, this week. I'll probably put a video up on the All Things Baseball page on Friday, probably around Friday night. I'll probably make a baseball video, so I really do appreciate it if you could check out the All Things Baseball channel. I'll link it in the description below, and that's going to do it for this video. Hope you guys enjoyed. I'll talk to you guys next time. Let's go Yankees!